President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. vows to strengthen the local economy and enhance food production to further bring down inflation. Marcos assured the public his administration will continue to implement programs focused on keeping prices stable. Economic Secretary Arsenio Balisacan says the Interagency Committee on Inflation and Market Outlook will closely monitor the uptrend in international rice prices and the impact of the El Niño phenomenon. Meanwhile, the central bank says it plans to keep monetary policy settings sufficiently tightened until there is a sustained downtrend in inflation. An economist agrees rate cuts may not be coming anytime soon.
Although inflation has come down to within target, we think in the first 4 months of next year, it's going to be below target. We think maybe second half of the year, the BSP will have more room to cut rates when they're fairly sure that inflation in 2024, 2025 will actually be within target.
Philippine inflation eases for a third straight month to 3.9% in December 2023. That's the lowest level recorded in nearly 2 years. It also falls within the central bank's forecast of 3.6 to 4.4%. Inflation cooled primarily due to the lower year-on-year price increases in housing, water, electricity, and fuels like gas. But one think tank maintains, the slower inflation rate missed low-income families. Citing government data, Ibon Foundation notes 30% of Filipino households still experienced higher inflation. Ibon says the government's policies may have not done much for the poorest Filipinos. An economist also warns upside risks to inflation remain in 2024.
It is not yet stable forecast because of the developments. Just now, for example, there is this fear for a wider war in the Middle East. So that one is a risk actually that we will be grappling with over the next few months, whether that will develop into a full-blown wider war, which definitely will affect the price of oil.
And here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of global delivery companies DHL, UPS, and FedEx. That's after India's antitrust body opened an investigation on the domestic units of the logistics giants over alleged collusion on discounts and tariffs. Also in focus, shares of Danish shipping giant Maersk, which has rerouted four container vessels that were stuck in the Red Sea back towards the Suez and around Africa to avoid the risk of attack. Maersk shares are down 1% as the move would incur fresh fees for passage through the canal and extra fuel costs. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Tesla after it announced a recall on 1.6 million vehicles in China to fix their steering software. Shares of Tesla tumble nearly 1% on the news.
The global economy poised for another tough year in 2024. That pronouncement coming from United Nations Chief Antonio Guterres, as the agency's latest report showed global economic growth will slow from an estimated 2.7% in 2023 to 2.4% in 2024. The UN cited high borrowing costs, sluggish international trade, rising debt, geopolitical tensions, and increasing climate disasters as significant challenges. Guterres now urging nations to unlock big and bold investments to put the global economy on a stronger growth path. He also called for more climate action. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. orders the country's energy regulator to fast-track the reset of the National Grid Corporation's rates following the three-day power outage in Panay Island. The president slammed the grid operator's failure to act during a supposed two-hour window to prevent a system collapse.
Accountability lies with the NGCP. They are tasked with grid stability. Stability involves proactive responses to breakdowns and unexpected events, a duty that NGCP, unfortunately, has not fulfilled adequately. As the systems operator, NGCP must proactively engage with distribution utilities and cooperatives to manage loads and prevent such system collapses.
The Energy Department, meanwhile, calls on Congress to review the NGCP's franchise as it recommends stripping off the agency's system operator function so that it can focus on its transmission network projects. It also supports a possible fine of 2 million pesos per day for the blackouts. As for the NGCP, it says it's not totally at fault over the incident. It cites external factors, including right-of-way issues, for posing challenges to its operations.